Are ocarinas actually easy to learn? This is a point of debate in the ocarina community. Some people think it's harmful to set the expectation that learning the ocarina is easy, when learning any instrument is hard. And honestly, learning an instrument is hard. There's no debate about that. But today we'll be answering the question, is the ocarina actually easy to learn? Let's get started. Before we begin, remember to hit subscribe and remember to leave a like at the end of the video. Okay, so how many of you in elementary school had to learn how to play the recorder? I'm gonna guess that a lot of you simply couldn't get the hang of it. Although I can confidently consider myself a musician now, the recorder was tough for me back when I was like 9 years old, despite it being allegedly an easy instrument to learn. If we compare my attempts to learn the recorder compared to my attempts to learn to play the trumpet was actually a lot harder. If we consider how much I practiced the recorder in elementary school, which was maybe 20 or 30 minutes a week, versus playing the trumpet every day, 5 days a week in middle school band, it makes sense that I got the hang of the trumpet. In fact, I became first chair of the trumpet section, and that's where I discovered my love for music. But again, that's because I played the trumpet daily for 4 years, although the recorder might be technically an easier instrument to learn. That all said, learning any instrument isn't easy. But I strongly believe that the ocarina has an easier learning curve compared to most other instruments, at least for reaching basic proficiency. While I did have 4 years of wind instrument experience under my belt when I started learning the ocarina, it only took me about an hour to be able to basically play easy songs. Results will absolutely vary, but I'd wager with the ocarina, anybody with proper resources and a functioning instrument could get to basic playing within an hour and basic proficiency within a month of regular practice. Grab a method book by my friend David Eric Ramos, and maybe grab a Knight by Noble, which is the most recommendable starter ocarina in my opinion. Affiliate link in the description. Do that and you'll probably have an easy breezy start to the ocarina. But I specifically said an easy breezy start to playing the ocarina. I believe they're also a challenge to master, as with any instrument. It could take you many, many years to reach like master level with the ocarina, but again, this applies to literally any musical endeavor. Of course, there are things like slowly getting better at reading music, better at moving your fingers, muscle memory, things like that. Every musician's journey includes mastery of their music and their instrument. And ocarinas have a lot of unique areas of challenge on that road to mastery. Every individual ocarina has its quirks. These are both Alto C plastic ocarinas, but they have their differences. And beyond that, there are a lot of advanced techniques to your ocarina playing that, given how individualized every ocarina is, I would consider these more to be philosophies to explore and apply rather than specific techniques that you can use across the board. For example, something as simple as playing in tune consistently is a challenge. If you overblow on any note, you'll go sharp, and if you underblow on any note, you'll go flat. As such, ocarinas technically only have one in-tune volume per instrument, and they're typically louder on higher notes. But let's think about that for a second. If overblowing or underblowing affects pitch and volume, what if you could, I don't know, let's say underblow an F sharp to get a quieter F natural, or overblow that same F sharp to get a louder G? Let's do a quick demo of those pitch dynamics. We'll use an F sharp as the bass, and then we'll hit both a loud G and a quiet F. Here's a G for reference. And here's an F for reference. So F sharp. I've been playing the ocarina for over a decade, and I scarcely explore this type of methodology, given its relative inconsistency. It's extremely hard to transfer any of these skills from one ocarina to another, because every ocarina is different in just about every one of its attributes, from breath curve to potential alternate fingerings, which we'll go over later. But these overblowing and underblowing dynamics have some legitimacy. While traveling in Seoul, South Korea during my university summer break in 2019, I had a jam session with Korean ocarinist Mary Yu, and her warm-up sheet included this exact concept. Overblowing a C to get a louder C sharp and underblowing that same C to get a quieter B. She practiced these exercises daily as warm-ups. So this is all to say that I'm not theorizing about, oh, maybe you could underblow an F sharp to get an F natural. No, this is things that actual professional ocarinists do and practice and employ in their performances. On a similar vein, what if you could use alternate fingerings to get the same note? This is a fingering for an E on my Alto C Night by Noble. But if you cover this subhole, then it's an E flat. Instead of the textbook fingering, I prefer this fingering for my E flats, and it's almost completely perfectly in tune. And that alternate fingering pretty much works on any 12-hole ocarina, though you might need to do some adjustments to your breath to be consistently in tune. There are many potential alternate fingerings you can use on a lot of different ocarinas, and the main point of using these is that some fast parts of songs might be easier if you use the alternate fingering instead of the standard one. Minimizing finger movement lets you play things faster, and some alternate fingerings minimize finger movement. But when it comes to advanced techniques on the ocarina, this is just the tip of the iceberg. The tip of the iceberg that must be applied differently on every single ocarina that you own and play. Next up, let's talk about extending range. There are two extremely consistent techniques for 12-hole soprano C ocarinas as well as 12-hole alto C ocarinas for extending your range. Normally, the range of a soprano C ocarina is from A5 to F7, which is a little more than an octave and a half. One common range extension method for the soprano C is called the Spider-Man method, and that's because your hand looks like this when you're doing it. I'll zoom in for the demonstration, but basically, with your middle finger, ring finger, and thumb, you only cover those appropriate holes, and then you overblow on your ocarina, hitting an overtone, which is actually generally an in-tune G natural. Moving away from my mic for the sound test so I don't destroy your eardrums, we'll do a quick scale. That's the normal highest note. Here's the G the soprano C can play. Then here's the Spider-Man method. Pretty in tune. My cat does not like these high notes, so that's all you're gonna get. Do I generally recommend that you use this method? No, I don't. Soprano Cs tend to be really loud, and there's high risk of ear damage if you overblow on them. However, if you're performing a song that is best played on a 12-hole soprano C, and you have a couple Gs that you have to hit here and there, go for it. This technique is a great tool for your arsenal, but if you have an ocarina that has a wider range, I would recommend that you simply use the ocarina with a wider range instead of extending the range of ocarinas you have. Like, use a double or triple ocarina instead of your 12-hole if you have something with this wide of a range in your notes. But there are scenarios when this is most viable. Next up, here's a technique to extend the range on a 12-hole alto C. I've covered this in a video before, so click the card right there if you want more details, but we'll do a quick summary. This is typically called the Milt technique, named after the Japanese jazz ocarinist of the same name, Milt. Basically, you position your hand something like this, having your thumbs together on the back, making basically a seal on the back of your ocarina. Here's what it looks like on the backside. Normally, a 12-hole alto C ocarina's range is A4 to F6, which is, again, a little over an octave and a half. But with the Milt technique, you can extend that range way, way higher, depending on the ocarina. Most 12-hole alto C ocarinas can consistently hit the G above the high F, but anything higher than that is really inconsistent. For example, on my Night by Noble, I can consistently not only hit the G, but also the A above that, and then the C above that. All it takes is some hand repositioning to make this backside a little bit smaller, or like rotating or whatever. I don't know the physics, it just works. Here's a demo. Moving my mic away yet again to preserve your ears. So here, we'll start with a regular scale of the range. Here's the lower G for reference. Using the Milt technique, we'll hit the high G. Then if you want to hit the A on the Night by Noble, you can consistently cover the four holes with your right hand and then do it again. For reference. And then I forgot my method for the high C, but I used to be able to do it consistently. The technique works on just about any 12-hole alto C ocarina, but the application varies from ocarina to ocarina. The adjustment I did to hit the high A on my Night by Noble would not work on another 12-hole ocarina. To demonstrate, a as you can tell by the struggle on my Spencer Ocarina of Time replica, I could only hit the high G and nothing above it. Not even using the exact same particulars for the high A that I did on my Knight by Noble. This is all to continually emphasize that advanced techniques on the ocarina vary from instrument to instrument. Whether that's the breath pressure dynamics to turn an F sharp into a louder G natural, alternate fingerings, range extension techniques, or all of that, everything varies from ocarina to ocarina when you get to the particulars of the technique. The philosophy is the same, but the technique is different. So this is why I believe that mastering the ocarina is applying philosophy, not just individual techniques. At this point, I really hope you understand why I say so. Technique is absolutely important, like it's called the Milt technique, not the Milt philosophy. But how you apply that technique varies from Alto C to Alto C ocarina. The best analogy I can think of is that it's like walking. You might innately understand the biomechanics of walking, but you have to adjust how you walk based on the shoes you're wearing and the terrain you're on. Walking with high heels on carpet will be very different from hiking with boots while hiking. Both of these scenarios are walking, but the way that you walk is very different. This is just like applying the same techniques to different ocarinas. You have to adjust the mechanics a little bit to make it work. And this is one huge reason why I don't believe anyone can say that there's a single best ocarina. While there are definitely ocarinas that are objectively better or worse based on things like tuning or ergonomics or pitch quality, so much of what makes an ocarina best for you is completely subjective. Because each individual ocarina has so many unique quirks and features for how you best play it, both in terms of basic playing and advanced techniques, not everyone will connect the same way to the same instrument. It's like how in Ireland they say the best whiskey is the whiskey you enjoy. You could hand me a $1,000 ocarina, but if it has a really low sensitive breath pressure requirement, I probably won't like it. Just like someone might love a $15 bottle of Fireball whiskey and absolutely hate a immaculately high quality $500 bottle of whiskey. The best ocarina is the one you enjoy playing. The caveat being, without technical issues caused by the instrument, such as being out of tune. Of course, it's important to go outside your comfort zone. Like, I could definitely learn to love that $1,000 low breath pressure ocarina. And that's part of the journey of mastering the ocarina. If you're an ocarina player and you want any singular takeaway from this, start trying some advanced techniques and see how they differ from ocarina to ocarina. Maybe wear earplugs if you're using the range extension techniques, but start try and see what happens. Get to applying that philosophy. And if you're considering buying a new ocarina yet have an ocarina you've yet to master, watch my video on when not to buy new ocarinas to help you in that decision. Don't waste money. Thanks for watching. Leave a like and subscribe for more. Watch that video next, and happy tooting. See you next time.